All right, we are set and underway. Kickoff goes into the end zone, and the Yellow Jackets will take over first and 10 at the 25-yard line. Far side of the field, one to the left. Latrell Ray in the backfield. Wasel lofts one, going deep. He's got a man. It's caught. And the Jackets strike first with a big play on a perfectly thrown pass from Steele Wasel.
Their one and only state championship came in Class 3A back in the year 2000, so they've grown fast. That's Latrell Ray. Makes one man miss, makes another man miss, and is down the sidelines, and he is out of bounds before he could get into the end zone. But excellent quickness. Choctaw has it first and goal from the 7. Ray, huge hole and into the end zone. Touchdown, Jackets. It takes him 43 seconds to go 80 yards, and Latrell Ray scores from 7 yards out, and Choctaw has a 6-0 lead. Bixby over Deer Creek, but the Spartans have moved on to Division I. So these two teams have a great chance to perhaps take home a gold ball. Kick coverage for the Jackets looked good initially. And a nice return for the Antlers to get it out to the 21. Adamson hands it to Miller. Miller breaks through the line and has a nice move and spins forward all the way out to the 43-yard line, and they move the chains on the first down.
Seeing them start this game in an I formation, getting physical right off the bat and running the ball. Got a little screen out to the right here. You got to love the offense, man. Like, they're playing with confidence for sure.
Adamson pitches it. Looked like there was an attempt to tackle up around the headgear. Adamson back to pass. Avoids the rush, and here comes a blitz late, and it's a sack. A big tackle for the Yellow Jackets.
Yeah, you got to love the young quarterback for Deer Creek rolls out to his left a little bit, but he's just got to get rid of the football, bottom line. Choctaw did a great job getting pressure right up the gut. Like Mark said, that defense pretty talented on the line of scrimmage. There was some pressure early, kind of thing spooked the quarterback just a little bit.
Side of the ball. They will rotate some underclassmen in on offense, but this is a veteran group rushing only 3, and Wasel has another dime right down the middle of the field to the 35-yard line. Wasel runs it this time into the line. I don't know.
To be able to just drop that ball in the bucket like he did right over the middle of the field, incredible accuracy, great poise. His form is incredible.
Wasel throws underneath, has his man. And the Antlers do a good job of umbrella defense here to force a fourth down and long situation.
What's going to happen here? They're going to throw it. Unbelievable. Wasel scrambles out to his left. He's looking. He's taking off down the field. And he only gets about 10 of what he needed to get there.
Adamson has Wilson to his left in the backfield. Adamson throws a pass in the flat, and that is an excellent play made by the Yellow Jackets corner fighting off the block, but the linebackers walked up here in a tight formation. Adamson is going to run the option, pitches it to Wilson, and the Jackets defense do a good job of stringing it out. That was an interesting play. Antler's going to get a first down. There was no one under center. The runners up in Class 5A last year were not treated very hospitably as the visitors in Coweta.
Either stay in the football field as long as possible. The last thing you want to do is have Wasel out there with the Choctaw offense. We know how explosive they are.
Adamson throws at the length of the field, and his receiver makes a man miss and goes deep into Choctaw territory. And so the Jackets got a sure tackle from the 26. Adamson hands it to Wilson, and Wilson has a good burst. Yellow Jackets. Adamson rolling to his right, has blockers out in front. 7-0. Latrell Ray gets the handoff, and the Deer Creek defensive line stands him up. 3-man rush. Wasel throws it in the flat, and there is a nice run.
You know, as much as you hate to do it, you understand wanting that extra member of the secondary out there, as Wasel could just tear you up through the air. I think you got to give Choctaw a ton of credit here, Deer Creek defense. Like Mark said, you know, 11 starters on this defense for Deer Creek. They know what they're doing, and they're playing technically sound football right now. That's a great tackle there on a quick out to the left.
motion for Juju Smith. And Ray takes the handoff, a little deception in the backfield, but Choctaw will pick up the necessary 2 yards. First down, Division I wins of their own over Westmore and Santa Fe. Wasel tosses it out. Ray on the receiving end, and Ray is driven back at the 40-yard line.
It's a little bit like that play that Jonathan Moxon ran with the Coyotes and with Bud Kilmer's offense. Running right up the gut, A-gap run. Once again, the interior of the Choctaw offensive line doing well.
We will try to update you. Latrell Ray getting up ahead of steam. Slipping and sliding his way down to the 23-yard line. Down to 2 to go. Wasel again hands it to Ray. Ray running to his left. He's got one man to beat. If he gets to the outside, he'll be gone. Ju Smith. So we'll see. If he is not back in the game, that will tell us everything we need to know. Wasel throws it out into the flat, and a host of antlers are there to make the stop, and no gain.
So I don't know what the story is. Maybe we'll get some more information at halftime. Right now, Steele Wasel with the ball running in the A-gap, gain of about 3 or 4 yards. We do get the handoff, and it is stopped immediately by Deer Creek. Is that a QB sneak? Handoff right up the gut. Touchdown, Yellow Jackets.
Welcome back. The Antlers receiving the kickoff and have a little return set up here. And they might have a big return set up. Sign of life for the Antlers on special teams as a fullback. Mason Miller lined up. It's going to be a little reverse pass. And they've got a receiver with some blocking out in front. It'll be a first down. Adamson fakes the handoff to Watson. And the catch is made. It's good coverage down the field.
Screen. Yeah, they're watching the previous play. Incredible. I've never seen anything like this set up out here. Ball is snapped. It's a handoff right up the middle. I don't know if they got there. It's going to be close.
Adamson. Option to his right, turns it up inside, and there is the Choctaw defense in pursuit. Adamson drops back, has a man caught, and doing a tight rope down the sidelines. It's going to be good for the first down earlier by 1, 14-13. Adamson pitches to Wilson. Wilson working his way through the defense and is down to the 3-yard line. Snap to Adamson. And this time the Jackets defense is strong and denies Wilson.
So standing in the end zone, shotgun formation, he hands off. Nice hold to the left side of that offensive line. They get right back to work running the football. Shotgun formation again. Handed it off again. Oh, no, Wasel takes it, runs off to the right, finds some space in the C gap, takes up off the field for about a 25-yard gain. Pass out to the left. Oh, about an 8-yard gain. Right. Hand off up the gut. No gain.
Welcome back, Choctaw, in punt formation. A little rugby punt. It is a missile and a good one. And it's rolling deep into Deer Creek territory. Pretty close to being even in this game. Adamson is rolling out to his right. Throws down the field, has a man caught at the 42-yard line. Jackets bring heat, has a man wide open, and it's caught. And let's see if the player can get out of bounds. He does get out of bounds. Nice reception. Adamson avoids a rush. I believe he's going to run with it. And he is brought down in bounds at the 22-yard line. Clock is now moving under 20 seconds. Adamson, pocket collapses, trying to stay behind the line, and he rushes, or runs the ball out of bounds.
Three-man front for Deer Creek. They're going to just hand it off and run it out. Big run here, big wide open hole. And that will be the end of the first half.
And we are underway here in the second half, and the Antlers are going to have pretty good field position to take over at the 33-yard line. Adamson takes the snap, hands it off to Wilson. Wilson running behind an offensive line, and he's got a big hole. It takes it out across the 45 and the 47, and the ball is out. Choctaw feels like they may have it. Adamson, screen pass to Mason Smith. Smith is able to break some tackles. A big hit laid on Smith in the secondary. Another long screen pass. And an excellent play by the Antlers, who's picking up yardage in chunks. First and 10 from the 25. Adamson to Wilson, and he is stopped by the man that Sam has been talking about all night, Marcus McGrew. Adamson, screen game again. Miller on the receiving end. Miller makes the first man miss before he's brought down by Austin Hubert.
First half of this, you would hope that at halftime they made some adjustments. Fumble on the play on the quick pitch there. Field goal attempt here for Deer Creek. It's up. It's good. Nice. They've basically gotten what they want. They've stopped themselves, honestly, more than I feel like Deer Creek has. Onside kick. Did it go the full 10 yards? It did go the full 10 yards, and it looks like, again, four receivers to the right. Another sideline pass. Another good athletic play. About a 20-yard gain there by Choctaw. That play goes away in the red zone, and that's the thing that's really kind of stuck out for both offenses. Whoa. Big-time block. Hand off right up the gut. 15, Addison. The left ball snapped. Hand off to the right side. Nice little hole. Addison sneaks through. He's moving. Turning those feet. Nice. Wasel takes it off to the left. He runs it in for a touchdown himself. Choctaw back on the board here in the third quarter.
To go. Jackets kick into the wind. It was really a tough break for Deer Creek on the onside kick. It worked extremely well. Point lead. Adamson hands it off to Wilson, and he is not finding much running room.
You know, I've had this conversation with Steele. Big, big, big sack. But he is a freak athlete, gets back there for a huge loss. And here comes Deer Creek with the punt. You know, as far as Steele to Akron, you know, I told him in person, we were working out at the gym, I just flat out told him, you know, keep your ears and eyes open for what happens this senior year. You never know who might come in and offer you late. What you're looking for here, you know, I would say that the difference between him and probably a top five guy might be the athleticism. You know, I think he's good enough on the high school level to be an asset in the run game. It should be, but clearly they've done a great job with developing him here in Choctaw. Great job by this coaching staff.
Well, that certainly was an unbelievable play if it's going to stand. And that ball was in a pile. The thing that impresses me so much about Steele, Sam, is that the effortless, how effortless it is for him to throw the football. It just really throws it on point. He doesn't try to overthrow. He's got a great motion. There's a big play from Deer Creek on special teams. Antlers put a few more men in the box, and as a result, do a better job of riding to side. And Ray gets it. It's a good decision from Wasel to hand it off to his speedy running back. And there goes Ray picking up some extra yards. Wasel again hands off to Ray. The Antlers step up to stop him. Dead concert. Wasel pitches to Ray. And the Antlers bottle that up.
Well, third down and about five. Still Wasel drops back, scrambles out to his right, fires. Short catch, short pass to Ray as he's up the field, and that kid's got a little jitterbug in him, no question. Nice 15-yard gain there in that play. You've seen them run the ball here, and they're getting ready to just a short passes and running the football as they move to the north. Ball snapped. Hand off to the right. Here comes Ray again, and he'll be tackled for a loss of about a yard. Three-man front from Deer Creek. Wow, big-time swim move right off the line of scrimmage by the nose guard here. Ball snapped, handoff right up the gut. There goes Ray with a quick little move.
The Jackets have four more downs in which to work. Wasel, screen pass. Caught, and nifty move. Handoff to Ray. Wasel, Ray, stopped in the backfield. This will bring up a fourth down again. Wasel. Stretch play. Ray's got blockers out in front. Oh, he's hit and drilled. But he gets the first down, but a big defensive play by the Antlers. Hand off again to Ray, and Ray is stuffed. Ray has it. And the Antlers get back there and get another stop. Wasel gets away. And he's going to run for a touchdown. Wasel, oh, he's hit inside the five. It looked like he might get to the end zone, but he picks up the first down. Wasel, stretch play. Ray fights forward to the one-yard line. Handoff goes to Ray, and the Choctaw offensive line pushing and fighting, and the clock continues to run.
All right, first down on the one. Wasel takes it, holds it. Takes it in for a touchdown here in the fourth quarter. And the kick is off. Not going to be any return here.
We'll be facing into that and an 18-point deficit. Adamson takes the snap. Got a wheel route and nice catch in the western half of 6A Division II. Adamson, oh, has a seat. A big rush by R.J. Jackson, potentially one and two seeds. That would be Stillwater and Muskogee. Muskogee behind Bird Ficklin. Oh, the ball is batted up in the air and intercepted. And that's R.J. Jackson. It doesn't matter. He could be in the backfield or he can be back waiting for a ball to pop up and go the other way. Injured Choctaw player was able to walk off the field under his own power. We had offsetting unsportsmanlike conduct penalties. And we have now had a fumble, and Deer Creek has taken the football back. So it is a second fumble. Was able to score 14 points in the final minute and 30 seconds. Adamson calls his own number, takes off down the middle of the field, and has a gain of 18 to the 30-yard line. Adamson is just dropped. Jackets going to bring four. Adamson has a man in the flat. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. Adamson rolling to his right, now back to his left, takes off over the middle of the field, and he's able to pick up a couple. It was under heavy. Adamson has a man. Great pitch, great catch underneath, and it's a first down. And again, that is Mason Smith. Choctaw is clearly a 6A school with all those tubas. No tubas in your band, you can play eight man. There's a nice catch again from Smith. Adamson underneath fires another completion, and that'll be good for the first down. Adamson rolling left, has a man caught, out of bounds, clock will stop. Adamson underneath has his man. Once again, it is Dalton. Adamson throws a deep pass and caught at the 10. Adamson hands off to Wilson, and Wilson is stopped. Adamson across the middle, touchdown. Ooh, that could be a little extra.
In this game, maybe got him out of their game plan. I would say the halftime adjustments here for Deer Creek were relatively effective. And, you know, you play this game again.
Left for Deer Creek. And the handoff goes to Latrell Ray, and he stumbles, but he's going to have the first down. Worthy. Mason Smith, the wide receiver for Deer Creek, has had a very good night offensively. Latrell Ray has it again, and he is stopped, and that is... Wasel. Hands it to Latrell Ray, and he's going to be stopped. and Deer Creek will use its final timeout. Choctaw will get the punt off. That ball is going to – we got a personal foul. Adamson is going to hand it off to Wilson, and Wilson goes forward to the 10. If you're looking for something to do tomorrow, check out Sam and I, a game day podcast, game day live. We will be in Norman at the Down Hotel. You can even stop by if you would like, but make sure that you interact with us during the Oklahoma-Texas game. That should be plenty of fun. As always, great job by our Skordle crew here tonight, and a good ball game. Choctaw. Looks like they may be the team to beat in Class 6A Division II, knocking off Deer Creek 28-16 tonight.